The Monkey King has built his throne on your back. A throne of gold and gem, polished with blood and tear. Throw off the Monkey King and his shining privy before your back is broken.
I am no beast of burden.
Thank you.
I am no beast of burden.
You there, a moment of your time.
I am no beast of burden.
Thank you.
I am no beast of burden.
I write this now in hope that someone will remain. Someone may remember. The sun is an orb of blood. Twisted twilight shrouds my eyes. The air reeks of anguish. San has plunged into nightmare. The man who served me coffee now writhes on the floor. He rants of visions he alone can see, as writhing red tentacles grow from his face, as if his eyes had been seeds waiting to sprout. He is quiet now, my waiter. No more cackling and screaming, dead. Of my fellow patrons, only two live. The others have fallen. Their blood is everywhere. The survivors, gemlings both, their skin shrivels and grays to the hue of necrosis. Their gems flare with unholy luster, their eyes black as hatred. A gemling ghoul, it twisted off a corpse's head, gnaws at skull like dog. My head now, visions clawing at me. Thinking burns. I see horror. Envy the mute corpses at my feet. Words flaming. Flee me. All is madness.
Beast of burden.
God bless you on this fine day, exile. God has glorious plans for us today. You ready, exile? Any moment now, this holy spot's going to be buried in filth. The corrupted will pour in here, bent on eclipsing anything and everything that has been touched by divinity. I hope you're good with a shovel, Exile. Glory to
mercy to the fallen.
You restore my faith in humanity, you do.
I shall wipe the filth from this house of God.
I am no beast of burden.
An emperor cannot allow himself to become buried in the shadowed vaults of self-doubt. Cannot allow thoughts of imagined disaster to spin about inside his mind like so many strife-splintered wheels. An emperor navigates his way through the terrors of perplexity with his eyes set firmly on the rising sun.
Beast of London.
Thank you.
I am no beast of burden.
There is nothing eternal in this empire of ours, but the names of our day that shall be revered or reviled in the centuries to come.
An emperor cannot allow himself to become buried in the shadowed vaults of self-doubt, cannot allow thoughts of imagined disaster to spin about inside his mind like so many stripe-splintered wheels. An emperor navigates his way through the terrors of perplexity with his eyes set firmly on the rising sun.
Yeah. How you doing?
Thank you.
The shadow whispers and simpers at the Monkey King's feet. When the Monkey King puts his back to the sun, it is the shadow that leads the way.
Something eternal remains in this empire. The question is, how? Damnation, my dear! I am no beast of burden.
Still breathing, eh?
Okay. over here, Exile. You in the mood for some hunting? If so, I have the perfect quarry for you. I've a certain pack of vermin in mind. Stronger and more vicious than most. Track them to their home territory and wipe them out. For this hunt, I'm going to share a piece of bushcraft with you. Well, bushcraft smeared with thaumaturgy. The corrupted creatures tend to mark their territory with their foulness. This trick allows you to pick up that scent and follow it home. The whole thing stinks of corruption, I know. But you can't expect to put your nose to the ground without getting it dirty.
You are not a cockroach. Strange. Inundated with cockroaches, I am. Black ones, four limbs, nasty, spiky things. Are you spiky? If so, my ribbons will pluck your spines. Malachi liked spines. Liked my spine. Pretty spine. Bejeweled and bountiful. Enough to make an empire weep. Do you weep, not a cockroach? I do. Tears are infinite. Why, on this very day, I've found a new reason to cry. The ribbons are order. Clean and polish. Serve and protect. Then those cockroaches crawled in. Swarmed through the cracks. The ribbon spool is taken. Stolen. The black ones want them, my ribbon. Want to wrap the city in black ribbons. Find the spool, not a cockroach. Look to my doorstep. Where the ribbons crush cockroaches yet. Bring the spool and I will find gratitude for you. You may go.
I awoke, feverish and barely conscious. I set to drawing these maps through the sable hours. By morning, my fingers ached, my eyes burned, yet still I found no rest. The reverie commanded its rendering. The reverie device now stands completed. I've placed the first of my maps within its receptacle. I've taken my maiden voyage into nightmare. I know now that which sent me this precious gift. It knows me, expects my return. It would be foolish to disappoint. Malachi.
I am no beast of burden. I am no beast of burden.
Thank you.
You there, a moment of your time.
I am no beast of burden. I am no beast of burden. I am no beast of burden.
They are my ribbons forevermore. Forevermore. I hate forever. I could tear happy ever after from Bard's bleeding tongues. You're still here, not a cockroach. Oh, gratitude. Yes, I should give you a token. A token. What token? This? Is this to your liking? The cockroaches will come again. They want the twist. That cockroach emperor. The other bugs shout his name. Ravisius. Cross the river, squash the emperor cockroach in his nest. The bridge. It is barricaded. That spawns a tricky question. Questions. Questions. I asked too many questions. Chit has told me so. I asked where it all went. Our feculence. He made them show me. Under the river, the sewers from this side to that. Filthy, fetid tunnels like a rower's cloaca. A black place, crawling with the undying. Once beautiful and arrogant gemlings, now the foul waste of the Empire. Fitting, isn't it? Apt. 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 I like you, not a cockroach. I like that you listen. It would annoy me if the Undying murdered you. Thormetic sulfite, that's what you need. A nasty, nasty substance it is. Melikai had his slaves mine it. Carry it from northern mountains to the refinery by the docks. Ezomites, Maraketh, Karui. It killed them all. Fevered the blood and scorched the mind. But you are clever, not a cockroach. You will keep it at arm's length. You will bring it to me so that I may make you something. An infernal talc that will bring furious light to undying darkness. Goodbye.
You there. Let me bend your ear for a moment.
I am no beast of thunder.
Even more full of yourself than last time, I see. The bigger the head, the badder the fall, my old man used to say. Walk around Rayclass with an attitude like that, and you're going to wind up in some undying's larder. Allow me to arrange the beating of some sense back into you. Let's see you knock me on my ass. Quick as you can. I doubt this will be a satisfying fight, so it may as well be a fast one. Are you game? Who taught you how to fight? Your mum!
I am no beast of burden.
Put your back into it! Now, well now, don't the spirit of Deresso smile on you? I'm still his favorite, of course, but he's got plenty of love to go around. Speaking of sharing the love, come see me on your next jaunt into the San encampment. I reckon we've got some talking to do.
I am no beast of burden. I am no beast of burden.
You get him, boy. Now there's a familiar face. Before you say anything, yes, I did try to kill you. Inexcusable. I allowed pragmatism to overcome honor in a moment of desperation. Please accept my deepest apologies. And what do you say? Can the two of us make a fresh start? Marvelous! Now, as you've clearly noticed, the Allflame has given me another respite from oblivion. Alas, it's a partial success only. I am neither man nor spirit, living nor dead. A state that comes with some rather frustrating restrictions. I know we've only just been reacquainted, but to put no finer point on it, I need your help. Interested, are we? Oh, splendid! In return, I have a gift or two that I may bestow upon you with a click of my translucent fingers. All you need do is furnish me with a crystal decanter and a juicy piece of fruit. Two humble items that remain agonizingly out of reach for a man in my peculiar situation.
There's my favorite fighter. I've just been putting some finishing touches on a few martial bits and bobs. Rather nifty they are, if I do say so myself. In fact, I do believe I'm getting better at this frontier shopkeeper malarkey all the time. Certainly developing an eye for quality at any rate. Must be your good influence rubbing off me. So feel free to peruse my wares any time you like. Mates rates guaranteed. At your service.
The Gemling Queen? She's impossible. How did she survive? Why is she not one of the Undying? No, these questions can wait. There's a more pressing one. Is she safe from the Ebony Legion? You've been busy. With the spool back where it belongs, the ribbons should be able to keep the Ebony Legion at bay. We've both seen what they can do to a man. Whether you were saving your own skin or thinking of others, it matters little to me. You succeeded where I did not. You have stood in the presence of the Gemling Queen. I can only hope to meet her in my nightmares. Now you must leave me.
authority will prevail.